all our prayers. We thank you because you answer all our inner desires. Father, let our worship rise up to you. Let our worship come up to you, Lord. Let it be present sacrifice. We sacrifice worship. We look beyond that which we feel, Lord. We look beyond that we see, Lord. And we worship you. Because you are bigger than all these things. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors. The Bible says, we have overcome by the blood of Lamb. We remain rooted in your word tonight, Lord. We give you glory and we give you praise. We thank you because you will do that only which you will do tonight. We exalt you. We praise your name. Let's put our hands together. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Somebody put those hands together for Jesus. If you're glad to be in worship experience, the first worship experience of the year 2017, let me hear you make some noise. We give you praise, Jesus. All right, can we bring it down? We learned a song on Sunday and it's titled For Who You Are. I believe we remember it. I will worship you for who you are. Remember, can we do it together? I will worship you for who you are, Jesus. All right, let's try it again one more time. I will worship you. All right, that's good. That's great. All right, put those hands together for yourself. Hallelujah. Let's go. We give you praise, Jesus. We give you all the glory, Lord. We bless your name for who you are, Jesus. Are you ready? Yeah. Here we go. Stand in you and say,
stand in you, in your presence, thinking of the good things you have done. When in you, worship me. Holy, righteous, faithful to the end.
Savior,
Savior,
healer,
healer,
are you ready?
Redeemer,
here we go.
I will worship you for who you are. I will worship you for who you are. I will worship you for who you are. Jesus.
All right, with your hands lifted, let's do it again.
You for who you are.
Sing your presence, your presence is heard to me. Nothing like your presence, Jesus. I long to dwell with you, Lord. Your breath is heaven to me. Treasure of my heart and of my soul. Treasure of my heart.
Treasure of my heart and of my soul.
In my weakness, you are merciful.
In my weakness, you are merciful.
Redeemer of my past and present wrongs.
Redeemer of my past
and
present
wrongs. That's who you are, Lord. Holder of my future days to come.
Holder of my future days to come.
Let's sing it again. Treasure of my heart and of my soul.
Treasure of my heart and of my soul.
In my weakness, you are merciful, Jesus.
In my weakness, you are merciful.
Redeemer of my past and present.
Redeemer
Lord,
of my past and present.
Holder of my future days to come.
Holder of my
let's raise it up. In your presence, I'm alive again. He
that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty, and shall say of the Lord that He is my refuge and my fortress. In You will I trust, Jesus. Your presence, Jesus. Your presence, Jesus. There's nothing more like Your presence, Lord. In Your presence I find peace, Lord. In Your presence I find healing, Lord. There's nothing more like Your presence, Jesus. Your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Is heaven to me, Jesus. Spirit of God, we welcome You. There's nothing what more like You, Jesus. Holy Spirit of God, You welcome, You welcome. Have Your way, Lord. Ruin and deliver, Lord. Ina kosi andeli, brahadi kosi andeli avasha. Ina koso koso di anana sata la 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 sata. Unto You, Lord, we come.
There's nothing but more that will ever come close. No thing can compare. You are living hope, Jesus. Your presence, yeah. I've tasted and seen how a Savior's love of life. When my heart becomes free, when my shame is undone, oh Lord, Your presence.
Come and sing it together. Holy Spirit, You will welcome me.
Sing, Holy Spirit.
Lift our hands up and we sing it to our Heavenly Father. Your glory, Lord.
Your glory, God, is what I
want. To be overcome, Lord.
By Your presence.
Come and sing it again.
Let's sing, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit.
Come have Your way, Lord. Come have Your way, Lord. Even as we lift our hands to You, Lord, as we lift our hearts to You, Lord, come have Your way in our lives, Lord. Your glory, Jesus,
is what our heart longs for. To be overcome
by Your presence, Jesus.
Sing it together.
Worship you tonight. I like you to go out tonight and just give God worship in your home world. If you recognize that is the God of all wonders, He's the God of all miracles, He's the God of all might, He's the God of all innovation, He's the God that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think. When you go out tonight and just give Him the worship that He deserves, celebrate Him. If you have expectation to encounter His power tonight, and you just give Him worship. Lord, we worship You. We bless Your holy name. In Jesus' name we have worshipped. In Jesus' name we have worshipped. In Jesus' name we have worshipped. Tonight we're worshipping and giving God thanks and praising Him. The first month of the year 2017 is about to come to an end, and I want you tonight to praise and to worship God with understanding.
I want you to sing to him from the bottom of your heart, from the depths of your soul, with understanding that you have come to encounter the Almighty God, the one who does not change, the one who has power to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think. One of the things that worship does is that it provokes the manifestation of the power and the presence of God. And that's what I want you to have the expectation to encounter tonight. We're encountering God tonight as the God of miracles. We're encountering him tonight as the God of all power. We're encountering him tonight as the God of awesome wonders. And that is what I want you to hold on to tonight. Whatever it is, wherever it is, anything whatsoever, where you need divine intervention and the manifestation of the power of God, I'd like you to open your heart tonight, because all I hear in my mind and in my heart is the manifestation of the power of God as the God of all wonders. The Bible says in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 20 from verse 18, it says, "And Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem fell down before the Lord, worshiping him. And some Levites of the Kohathites and Korathites stood up to praise the Lord, the God of Israel, with a very loud voice. And they rose up early in the morning and went out into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went out, Jehoshaphat stood and said, 'Hear me, O Judah, and you inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, and you shall be established. Believe and remain steadfast in his prophet, and you shall prosper.' When he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers to sing to the Lord and praise him in their holy garments as they went out before the army, saying, 'Give thanks to the Lord, for his mercy and loving kindness endures forever.'" Verse 22 says, "And when they began to sing and to praise the Lord, the Lord sent ambushments against the men of Hammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, who had come against Judah, and they were slaughtered." Hallelujah. The act of praising God provokes divine intervention in this place. And that's what I wanted to have expectation tonight, to have manifested as we praise and worship God tonight. The Bible says in the book of Acts chapter 16, talking about Silas, Paul and Silas, where they were in prison. The Bible says at midnight hour, they began to sing and to praise God. And the Bible says that the place where they were shook and there was like an earthquake. The Bible says that the doors of the prison flew open. Okay, and their chains were broken. And so tonight, what we are doing in this place is provoking the hand of God to manifest as the God of wonders. It's provoking the hand of God to manifest as the God of miracles in every and any dimension in our lives. If you've come tonight with a burden in your heart, I'd like you to know that we're provoking God tonight to intervene on your behalf. If you have come overwhelmed with sorrow, I'd like you to know that the oil of joy is being poured out unto you in the name of Jesus. If you have come to celebrate God for what he has done in your life, I'd like you to know that tonight he's going to then do more than he's done already in the name of Jesus. So this worship tonight, I want you to lavish it on God with expectation of his divine manifestation. And so can we go ahead tonight and just begin to thank God for the things that he's going to do in this place tonight? Can you just give him your praise tonight for the expectation of the things that he's going to do tonight? Can you worship him and give him praise for all of those things? And I'd like you to begin to name them one by one, the expectations that you have in your heart. The areas of your life where you want to see the manifestation of the hands of God. The areas in your life where you want to see the manifestation of God as the God of miracles, the God of wonders, the God of all power, the God of all might, the God of judgment, the God, the King. I'd like you to go ahead tonight and begin to give God praise, celebrate him, give him worship, because the Bible says he's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think. I'd like you to open your minds and have your faith charged tonight, holding on to God. The Bible says that we should look unto him as the author and the finisher of our faith. He's able to do much more than we can ask or think. And so, Father, tonight we give you praise. We give you worship. We will honor you tonight in the name of Jesus. And so in 1 minute, I'd like you to lift before God tonight whatever it is, or any area of your lives where you want to see divine intervention as you praise him tonight. In any particular area, I'd like you to mention those things and begin to provoke God. Begin to challenge him to manifest in the name of Jesus. I'd like you to begin to provoke God to manifest in the affairs of your life. In the name of Jesus, whatever area it is, I'd like you to provoke him tonight and ask that it will manifest in the name of Jesus. If there be anybody here tonight who is far away from God, if there be anybody here tonight who has lost the joy of salvation, I'd like you to worship God tonight with open heart, because I believe that God is reconnecting with you. The Holy Spirit is coming into your heart afresh. I'd like you to pray tonight because the heavens are open. I can feel the rivers of the Spirit of God flowing in this place. And it's connecting with everybody at the point of their needs. And so tonight, praise Him with understanding. Praise Him with understanding, with expectation of His divine manifestation in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Psalm 114, it says, "What ailed you, O mountain, that you skipped at the presence of God? What ailed you, O hills, that you skipped like lambs at the presence of God?" And so tonight, I'd like to say to you that things are moving. Ways that doors are opening, mountains are moving in the name of Jesus. God is the one who is able to level the mountains. He's the one who is able to make the crooked path straight. And we're encountering Him like that tonight in the name of Jesus. I'd like you to know that we're encountering Him like that tonight in the name of Jesus. He's the one who is able to make crooked path straight. He's the one who is able to make water, rivers to flow in the desert. He's the one who is able to turn the wilderness to a road. And we're encountering Him tonight in all sorts of ways, in the manifestation of His power, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank You tonight for open heavens. We thank You for the manifestation of Your power. We thank You, Jesus. We thank You, Jesus, because You're the Onisheyanu. We thank You, Jesus. You're the one who is able to do much more than we can ask or think, much more than we can imagine, in the name of Jesus. We thank You, Lord, tonight, for burdens have been rolled away. We thank You tonight, oh God, for hearts have been connected to You. We say be exalted tonight in the name of Jesus. Oh, thank You for tangible manifestations, tangible connections with Your power tonight. Lord, we give You praise. We give You worship tonight. We give You praise tonight. We worship You. We bless You tonight. Can we sing to Him, Onisha Yadim, one more time? And just sing to Him that we expect Him to manifest in His power as the Onisheyanu. Onisheyanu means the wonder-working one. The one who's able to do exceedingly. Father, we worship You tonight. We bless You tonight, Jesus. Oh, we worship You tonight.
Is a great and mighty God. Lift your hands, come on. Celebrate the Lord. Lift your voice and celebrate. Say, Lord, I celebrate You, Lord. We abide in Your presence, Lord. We abide in Your presence, Lord. Because You are a sure foundation. You are our refuge, Lord. Lift your voice. Come on, lift your voice. Lift your voice. Psalm 91 says, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord is my refuge. I will say is my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely He will deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover me with His feathers, and under His wing shall I trust. His truth shall be my shield and buckler. I shall not be afraid for the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day." Somebody say, "I shall not be afraid for the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that walked in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasted on new day. 1,000 shall fall." I say, 1,000 shall fall at my side, 10,000 at my right hand, but it shall not come near thee. Only with your eyes shall you behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou art made the Lord, which is thy refuge, even the Most High, the habitation. There shall no be evil before thee.
neither shall any plague come near their dwelling. For shall give his angels charge over you to keep thee in all your ways, and you will bear, they will bear you upon their hands. These are dash their foot upon against the stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder, the young guy and the dragon shall thou trample under your feet, because he has set his love upon you. Therefore will he deliver you. He said he will set you on high, because you have known his name. You will call him and he will answer you. He will be with you in trouble. He will deliver you and honor you with long life. 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 Someone said, with long life. With long life. Will he satisfy me? With long life. Will he satisfy me? And he will show me his salvation. We thank you, Lord, your anchor, Lord. We rest in you, Lord. I have this soul. Let's sing together.
I have this soul
as an anchor for my soul.
As an anchor for my soul.
Somebody say, through the storm.
Through every storm.
I will hold in you, Lord. I will not be afraid. I will trust in you, Lord. I will not be afraid. I behold you, Lord, with endless love. Sing with me, sing with me. All my fears is swept away. Open your mouth and shout in everything. I will trust in you. Say, in everything, I will trust in you. Everything, Lord,
you gave
everything to save the world, and this hope will be an anchor for my soul. Somebody shout, our God will stand, unshakable, that's who you are, unstoppable, that's who you are. Make some noise. Bless your name, Lord. Is the unchanging ones. Let's sing together. Say,
unchanging.
You was an easiness to God.
You was an easiness to God.
Lift your voice to me. Say, your promise sure.
Your promise is sure.
You will never let go. Yes, inscribe you on the palm of his light hands this evening. Oh, we see every
soul
in the promise of the Lord. He gave everything to this world that he loved. And his hope will be. Lift your voice. As you shout, your name, your name, your name, say, your name, say, let me hear you.
My hope is in you.
Your Somebody say, chains will break tonight. As heaven and earth, as the elevation chant worship, holy is your name. Holy is your name. Jesus, shout Jesus. Let's do it one more time. He will say, here we go, say, he
say, will say,
I tremble.
I tremble before.
Somebody shout, chains.
Disciples shouted and called out to Jesus, and the Bible said the storm stilled. Somebody will walk on water tonight. Jesus, name of all awful names, Jesus, lily of the valley, Jesus, king over all, bright and morning sun. Jesus, you shine, you reign, Jesus, you rule, Jesus, my God, my Lord, Jesus. You reign, Jesus. You rule, Jesus. We call your name, Jesus. We worship you. Reigning King, Lord over all, we worship you. You are crowned, Lord. And crown me, Lord. And crown me, Lord. We crown Jesus. Somebody say, Lord. We crown Thee, Lord. We crown You, King. We crown You, Master. We crown You, Savior. We crown You, Ruler. We crown You King of all, conqueror of the universe. We crown You, 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 Lord of all. Of all. Oh, hail the power of Jesus. There we go.
Jesus,
name.
Jesus.
Wave your hands to him and crown him Lord of all over this place. Lord, we crown you King of Kings, immortal, invisible, the only wise God. We lift your name high in this place tonight. We lift your name. Father, we thank you. Lord, we bless your name. We give you glory and we give you praise. In the precious name of Jesus, we have worshiped. I said, in the precious name of Jesus, we have worshiped. Will you put your two hands together and celebrate Jesus tonight? Please, you may take your seat. That was some bit of rehearsal. We're getting into the main thing gradually. And as we progress in the service tonight, I just want to encourage someone with a verse of the scripture. The Elevation Priest of Praise will come back and we'll get into some more intense time of worship and praise. Praise God. I said, praise God. Someone is here tonight with really, you know, intense emotional disturbance. I don't know who you are, but God knows you. I just want you to know that the time of worship and the time of praising, singing, of the goodness of our God, singing of his mercy, it's a time of healing for emotional troubles. Before I go into the main verse that the Holy Spirit put in my heart, I just wanted to check out something about the life of David. David won many great battles, but he had many great issues, especially emotional issues, issues in his personal life. When you look at him outwardly, you see a mighty man of war. But when you look at him, look around him, he was a man who suffered a lot of emotional disturbance. But at every point in time, I'm saying this tonight so that as we resume worship, you will know how to direct your attention. Because some people here tonight, some things are still overriding on your mind, and you're still trying to key in, and you're looking for the angle where to, you know, come in from, and you seem to be struggling a bit, just trying to locate the right place. And I want you to know that the right place is for you to let go of some of the things, some of the prevalent thoughts on your mind. One of the reasons that I believe that David was able to prevail with God in a lot of his situations was that he knew how to manage situations and how to end up in God's presence. I mean, this happened to be an organized gathering for us to worship. David used to organize himself just to stay alone, to just worship. Some of the issues he went through in his life, some of us, if you just experience just a little of it. Let me give you some example. In Psalm 54, in Psalm 52, David had experienced great oppression by Saul, and he became a fugitive, yet he had been anointed to be king over Israel. So Saul will come after him. Saul tried to pin him to the wall twice. At close range, threw the javelin at him. David will escape from that kind of place and then find a little corner and he will start to sing to God. So that's what you see in Psalm 54. That's what you see in Psalm 18. That's what you see in Psalm 52. What do you do after you have experienced that kind of attack? Do you go somewhere and say, what kind of rubbish oil did Samuel put on my head? What kind of delay, what kind of destiny is this that is just suffering delay? Somebody anointed you and he said you are now king over his people. God has chosen you. And then you have to go through all this mess.
Somebody's listening to me tonight. God spoke to you about a business. To start it has become trouble. You have looked for a store you can't find. Let me manage here. They said no. What do you do when you're experiencing delay? What do you do when somebody's really after you? David found something that worked for him. And that's to locate himself in the presence of God. And just pour out his heart in singing. In singing. And you know, in his presence, the Bible says that there's a fullness of joy. That joy, you know, doesn't just come upon you because you are in his presence. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. You need to key into it. How do you key into it? You need to trust the Holy Spirit to help you to offload so that you can download. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. You can't be carrying this much in your heart and you think you can download anything. When you come into God's presence, you offload. Then you trust God to download. By offloading, I mean certain things have to, you just have to allow them to go. This is the presence of God in his presence. Mountains, they skip like rams. Burdens are rolled away. You just allow the burden to just shift. And then you can position to download something great in his presence. Somebody listen to me tonight. I said, somebody listen to me tonight. What do you think David should do after his experience, you know, with the Amalekites at Ziklag? They burned down everything. In 1 Samuel chapter 30, the Bible talks about David encouraging himself in the Lord is God. He did it singing. And whenever he started to sing, the presence of God would come down. It will allow the burden to roll away. And then he would download direction. David encouraged himself in the Lord is God. And then after he was, started to ask God, should I pursue? Will I overtake? Will I recover her? That's after you have allowed this heaviness to go. The fear to go. Fear of the unknown. Will this thing work? Will it not work? If you want to maximize God's presence tonight, you need to offload. So when it's time to lift up holy hands, lift it very well, like somebody who's not carrying any load. You know, there's a way you can lift up holy hands. Even the devil knows you are still carrying a load. And you say with me tonight, when you lift it like, you know, something is on your shoulder. Let the devil know that I've come to this place, I've come to his presence to just offload everything. To just roll my burdens at the altar and just let it be. Yeah. The sickness is not my sickness. It's the devil's sickness. He's trying to put it on me. So I want to, yeah. The Bible says, casting all your cares upon him. Can I encourage somebody here tonight? Have you come to cast your cares or have you come to worship with it? You know, there's a way you can stay in the place of worship. You know, you're carrying the cares here. You're trying to worship from here. So the moment worship is over, you just carry it back and just walk away. And there's no effect. It doesn't even look like you have spent time in his presence. Is somebody still with me tonight? I can go on and on and on. David experienced disloyalty and rebellion from his son Absalom. And in Psalm 3, when you read from verse 1 to 8, you see the songs that David, how David just was pouring out his presence, I mean his heart in the presence of God, about Absalom and this guy, this great, you know, this young man that is supposed to support his father. But have you suffered any kind of, you know, conflict with someone that's supposed to support you and, you know, disloyalty? Is anybody chasing you? What's work like? What has it been like this January? Don't allow all that to weigh you down in the presence of God. Take a different posture tonight. Take a different posture tonight. Take the kind of posture that was taken in 2 Chronicles chapter 20 when Israel was besieged by, you know, different countries. And Jehoshaphat had to lead them to battle. And God said, you know what? This is not your battle. This is mine. You know, this is our year of rest. we are to be steady and steadfast. You cannot be fighting battles and expect God to fight it with you at the same time. It's either you allow him to fight and you hold your peace and just enjoy his presence. And then you will see it was the same thing that happened to David. God just, you know, giving him direction, telling him what to do. That's what we gain when we come into God's presence, especially in the time of worship. Especially in the time of worship. And it was the same thing that Israel experienced in 2 Chronicles chapter 20. Bible says in verse 20, so they rose early in the morning and went out into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went out, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah, and you inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, and you shall be established. Believe his prophet, and you shall prosper. Verse 21 says, and when he had consulted with the people, he appointed those who should do what? I cannot hear you. Is anybody ready to sing to the Lord tonight? Because you are here on divine appointment also. Said he appointed those to sing to the Lord and who should praise the beauty of his holiness. And as they went out before the army and were saying, praise the Lord, for his mercy endures forever. Verse 22. And when they began to sing and to praise the Lord, the Lord set ambushes against the people of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, and who had come against Judah. And they were what? I cannot hear you. Said they were defeated. Says, for the people of Ammon and Moab stood against the inhabitants of Mount Seir to utterly kill and destroy them. And when they had made an end of the inhabitants of Seir, they helped to destroy one another. That can only be supernatural. So three people were against Judah. Two gang together, face number three, wipe them out. When they finish wiping them out, they now face each other and destroy each other. I see somebody sharing that kind of testimony. If I'm talking to you tonight, this is how you will know. You are trying to block one thing off your mind, you are remembering another one. I mean, you can imagine the situation with Jehoshaphat. Who should he think about? Is it Moab or Ammon or Mount Seir? Because there are three of them who have come together. And when God will do it, he said, Moab and Ammon, join together. Deal with Mount Seir. When you finish, deal with yourselves. That's what the power of praise can do. That's what can happen when you don't even know how to fight, but you decide to leave it in the hands of God. If Israel were to fight the three, where would they have started from? Would they start with Ammon first or with Mount Seir? What? All they did was to sing, praise the Lord, for his mercies endure forever. Jump on your feet, somebody. Jump on your feet, somebody. Lift your two hands like somebody who's not carrying anybody. Let the devil know tonight that you have come to drop everything at the altar. Whatever the name of the body may be. It may be Ammon, it may be, you know, whatever. Moab or Mount Seir. Just let the Lord know. Lord, tonight I've come to roll my burdens, my career burdens. You know, I've come to roll the burden concerning that contract here. Maybe the contract is the Moab. Tonight something is happening to it. Whatever is holding it down, as we praise the name of Jesus, as we sing of his faithfulness, as we sing of his mercy, as we sing of his sovereignty, something is giving way tonight. Burdens have been rolled away. Yokes are destroyed. Lift your two hands to Jesus. Call him the God of mercy. Call him the God who is faithful. Call him the God who is faithful. Call him the wonder-working Father. Call him the glorious King. Call him the one who does great things. Somebody call him his name tonight. 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 If you are distracted, you may need to close your eyes and just tell yourself, it's me and God here tonight. It's just me and God here tonight. It's me and God here tonight. I just want to roll all the burdens away. I want to cast my cares upon him and position to download.
Trust in you, Lord. Your refuge and our strong tower, our fortress. We don't know we hide in you, Lord. We are steady and we are steadfast. No shaking. I said we are steady and steadfast. There's no shaking. We are winners. We are winners. We are winners. We are conquerors. We are more than conquerors. Through him strengthen us. You fight our battles. We hold our peace. Come on, one more time. Just worship in his name. Come on, don't be tired. Come on, don't worship, worship, worship. I'm waiting for you to worship him. Somebody shout, somebody sing, somebody dance, somebody clap. Somebody proclaim and declare. We are winners, we are the winners. We are winners. We are winners, we're winners, we're winners. We are winners, I'm a winner. I overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. Trust the sweetest thing. But we wholly trust in you, Lord. We say those words again. My hope is safe.
My hope is built on nothing else
than Jesus' blood and righteousness, saved. I dare not trust the sweetest name.
I dare not trust the sweetest
name. Only trust in Jesus' name.
Only trust in Jesus.
Christ,
cornerstone.
Wait, make strong. In the Savior's love. I know through this time you will come. Somebody shout, hey, yeah. You are Lord of all. You are Lord of all. You are Lord of all, say. I rest on his unchanging grace, say. In every heart and stomach, girl. Say those words. My anchor is within the veil. Say it. Lord, and stand in you, Lord. We put our trust in you, Lord, and you gift us with your rest of all. We praise your name, we magnify you. Hallelujah.
When it shall come with trumpet sound.
It shall come with trumpet sound.
Oh, may I
found. Oh, may I then in him be found.
Dressed in righteousness,
Lord. Dressed in his righteousness, O Lord.
Stand before the throne.
Oh, faultless stand before.
Strong.
Strong.
In the Savior's love.
In the Savior's love.
You weather the storm.
Through the storm.
Is he Lord? Is he Lord?
He is
somebody
Lord.
Say, he's Lord, oh, Lord of all.
Lord.
Seeking ground on your promises and your word, we stand. We know all other ground is sinking ground. We build our trust, we build our hope, we build our assurance, we build our safety, we build our anchor. Only in you, Lord, we trust. Only in you, Lord, you are Lord over all. Through the storms, through any storm, Lord, you are Lord. This one too will pass in the name of Jesus. We bless your name.
beginning to the end. There is no, somebody say, you are God. I can hear you shout, you are God from beginning.
Praise the Lord in the house this evening and give him a shout.
We worship you, Jesus. You've got time and seasons in your hand. You call for light out of darkness. You don't need a man to be the God you are. But you have chosen to call me your own. Elevation Church, bless the Lord this evening. Bless the Lord this evening. You've got time and seasons in your head. You call for the light out of darkness.
ready with a shout up in the house this evening. And give him your own praise, give him your own worship. Sing him more than a song. Give him something fresh this evening. Give him something new. Sing melodies from your spirit to the King of Kings, the lover of your soul, the mighty man in battle, the one who delivers us from the hands of the enemies, the one who picked us up from the marine and set us on the rock to stay. He put a new song in my heart and praises to my God and King, the deliverer, the one who made a way where there seems to be no way. Worship him, worship him, worship him. Lift your hands and just leave them up. The Bible says, I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From where comes my help? My help comes from the Lord. They join with the angels and we worship you. They join with the angels and we worship. Hallelujah.
Your presence,
oh Jesus. Call his name Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Call his name Jesus. The latest thing before the Lord to this evening. Jesus. When I don't have any words to say, I say Jesus. Jesus. I say Jesus. I say Jesus. What a beautiful name. supposed to sing and praise. The heavens are roaring. Can you hear it?
The heavens are roaring.
The praise of your glory.
The praise of your glory.
For you are raised to life again.
For you are raised to life.
And the vision church declare, He has no rival.
You have no rival.
You have no equal.
You like have no equal.
Now and forever,
now
God, you
and
reign.
God, you reign.
Yours is the kingdom.
Yours is the kingdom.
Yours is the glory.
Yours is the glory.
Jesus, yours is the name
yours
above all names.
Is the name.
Can somebody declare it in the house?
Oh,
what a powerful name it is. What a powerful name it is.
What a powerful name.
Jesus Christ.
There is a lifting up. There is.
shout of victory. Come on. When for the world, Christ's darkness covers the people. Then for the church, the glory of the Lord is shining.
We're going to sing it again. Come on.
When for the world, darkness covers the earth.
Elevation to church, can I hear? Then for the church, what?
Then for the church,
our light has come.
When for the world, God's darkness covers the people.
Then for the church,
the glory of the Lord is shining.
Situation that there is a lifting up. Come on, break out, take a ticket, telephone. Break a ticket, telephone, ticket, telephone.
Everything within me. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh,
come on.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Everything within me.
Everything within me.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Oh my soul.
Everything within me.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Bless the Lord, oh my
Hallelujah. 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 Glory to Jesus. Before we round off the session of worship tonight, there's just one more thing that I want us to do that is ringing in my spirit. How many of us tonight believe that there's truly a lifting up in your life? That song says, when the word says there's a casting down, in the church, we will say there's a lifting up. As we were singing that song, the Spirit of God started to paint a picture in my heart. He said, you know what it means to be a lifting up. For there to be a lifting up in the church when the word says there's a casting down. And then the Spirit of God put in my heart the testimony of a sister. I was sharing with my wife earlier today. A member of this church that we've been praying with, you know, and all. I'm going to share that testimony because the devil doesn't like that testimony. And we're going to sing that song one more time to round off tonight. Was it yesterday or 2 days ago? I got a call from my husband. They've been away for a while. They just returned. Now, it was a very simple testimony. They've been trusting God for the fruit of the womb for a while. I think it was their fifth or sixth years. And, you know, it was just 5 or 6 years. You guys should take it easy. So we're praying along with them and just trusting God. And all of a sudden, while she was going through all that test and all, they discovered that she had a great health challenge, a degenerative disease. I think lupus or something they call it. Yeah. And her kidney seemed to, you know, just be draining protein, you know, and all those. And then the doctor said, you know what? Just forget about the issue of having a child. Don't even think about it again. She got 2 consultants. The 2 of them, one said, you know what? We're going to manage you and manage your life so you can live long. Forget about having a child. The other one said, you know what the first one said was, it's true. If you have a child, if you get pregnant, you're going to die. Yeah. I looked at a young man one day, and I was like, I was just wondering what could be going on in the heart of this guy right now. You know, I was thinking to myself, the devil will be speaking to this guy, that there's a casting down, that, you know what, just prepare, because you're going to have to find somebody else to marry, because this person is going to die. You can't have a child together, you know, and all that. The first thing that happened was like a sign. In the midst of nowhere, this lady got pregnant. She got pregnant and we're like, oh, what's going to happen, you know, and all that, with all the issues on ground. And then she started to have some challenges. And I remember the day I visited their home and I laid my hands on her. She just lost the pregnancy. Laid my hands on her. And I said, this affliction will not arise a second time. And I spoke a blessing over her. And I said, in this life that they've said, you will not conceive. And if you conceive, you're going to die. You will not die. You will carry your home baby. And we've all been praying along with them, the pastors and all. To cut a long story short, they're back in the country with their baby. When the word says there's a casting down, we will say there's a lifting up. The devil tried to strike because he got pregnant first. They lost that one. And the consultant warned them, it must never happen again because you are playing with your life. You get pregnant again, you are going to die. And then I remember she got pregnant again and she called. Remember, Pity, and we're talking, you know, just don't worry, you know. And they said, you know, hey, it's not going to work. And all of a sudden, it's not going to work. 3 months, 6 months. It happened to be one of the most blissful pregnancy you can think about. I mean, she will call us. She was in the UK for a while. She will call us from the UK and say, I don't feel anything. The baby is just growing. I'm not sick. I'm not, I was late.
are certain testimonies that can define what it means to be a lifting up. When the word says there's a casting down. Yeah? When the word says there's a casting down. I think it was last September I was in the UK. I called her up. I want to see, I want to see her stomach. I want to see everything because now it's, then was about maybe 7 months or so. Somebody that is said, if you get pregnant, you're going to die. You can't have a baby again. Your life, your body will just degenerate and that will be the end of it. She's had a baby 2-3 months now. She's strong, baby's strong. All the consultants disappointed. All forecasts. There is a lifting up. I said there's a lifting up. I said there's a lifting up. There's a lifting up. If you believe that, shout a big amen. Let the devil know tonight that there's a lifting up. If you believe there's a lifting up, let's sing that song one more time. Come on, drown somebody. Come on, run somebody. Let the devil know.
Church, our light has come.
Then for the church, our light has come.
Hey.
When for the world, cross darkness covers the people. Then for the church, the glory of God is shining. There is a lifting up. There is a lifting up.
Somebody's destiny here tonight as a lifting up.
Yeah.
Wherever the world has said that there's a casting down, it's due to the limited knowledge that they have. There is one person that knows all things and can do all things, and his name is Jesus. The Bible says, through him all things were made, and without him was nothing made that was made. And when he says there's a lifting up, then there's a lifting up. I declare over your destiny tonight as a lifting up. In 2017, there's a lifting up. In your business, there's a lifting up. In your career, there's a lifting up.